I have done all abilities of the main character. Now Castle can push his forward tower like a bowling ball in the crowd of enemies, or launch it in the sky like a rocket, breathe fire, shoot fireballs, or even vomit a jet of lava to hit a line of enemies. But all ranged attacks need fuel, and one of the ways to get fuel is to defeat enemies in melee. Therefore, you must balance between range and melee attacks. Also, Castle can restore his health and fuel by using some power reserve, which is displayed as flags under the health bar. Castle will start to laugh, set fire around, and if nobody buzzes him until the end of the animation, he will get a bonus power up. Enemies. At the start, I decided to not make a lot of enemies, but instead give a few kinds of enemies lots of abilities. Now wheat-filled monsters can block your attacks, hit you by using their tails, and in the future I will add other combat skills to them. All animations of attacks were done in advance. Glad to inform you that wheat-filled monsters are not alone anymore. Now they have spiky friends, spruce forest monsters. Spruce forest monsters attacks in distance by shooting spruce trees at you. To avoid damage, you must crouch. They do not just shoot, but charge spruce projectiles before an attack by squatting with air pump-like movement a random amount of times, and with every squat they become greener and increase the damage of spruce projectiles. Try to hit them before they shoot at you. Spruce forest monsters too, as wheat-filled monsters, will have a wide variety of abilities. For example, they can restore their health if you will not be in time to kill them, but all these abilities are not available at the start of the game. Enemies gradually acquire them with every next level as you. The core game loop consists of three phases. You fight with the first wave of enemies, then at the start of the second wave you and your enemies will get new abilities, and on the third wave you must fight with bosses. Bosses are just more powerful versions of ordinary enemies, but with new combat skills and changed characteristics. Also, if you hit a boss several times in a row, or pressed him against the boundary of the level, then he will charge power and discharge it on you, thereby pushing you away, but without any damage. I made this mechanic with the reason to prevent players from an easy win. When the boss is killed, you will go to the next level. That cycle repeats until the end of the game, and with every iteration the game gets harder and harder. Sound effects and music. Now the game has more than 200 various sound effects. Sound of moving floorways, boiling water, paper crumpling, and even cries of passenger on a roller coaster. Music that you can hear in the game was done by me for another project called Flower Gunpowder. To make the soundtracks, I was using a free random generator of guitar riffs, DJN, and Audacity. I wanted to make new music for Brutal Castle, but my new tracks sound awful, and also I not very like my previous game. Therefore, I decided that heavy metal music is more fit to beat 'em up about Brutal Castle than to the top-down shooter about pink-dressed rabbit which plants flowers in flower beds to kill cartoon moles. If you want to try that game, Flower Gunpowder available for free on my itch.io page. The especially important thing is to make a nice-looking menu. The menu is the first thing that players can see after launching the game. I drew the main character in the dense spruce forest and made the camera move to make a beautiful parallax effect. That is all I wanted to show you in this devlog. At that moment, all core game mechanics and almost all graphics were done. Now I should add other enemies, their abilities and levels. Sounds like a lot of work, but the most difficult things stayed behind. I plan to release this game on Steam in the next couple of months. And to get useful feedback and support, I made and polished the free demo version of Brutal Castle. The demo has two first levels, and you can beat them in just 8 minutes. But can you beat the game on the first try? Can you bake loaves of delicious crispy bread out of wheat-filled monsters? You must try it right now! I leave a link on the itch.io page in the description, and I hope you will enjoy the game. Thanks for watching, subscribe to this channel, like, leave comments below the video and follow me on Twitter. See you soon!